Yeah, it's a late unboxing. So this probably wasn't UPS's last delivery on this route tonight, but it was pretty darn close coming in at 6 p.m. But we have the Pacific Blue iPhone 12 Pro, and I'm super excited to check out and feel the new design. So let's get this thing open and go from there. Box feels like most Apple boxes. And it comes in upside down. Look at that. I just gotta say, first impression, that blue is nice. It's such a nice change to have a Pro phone that has some color. Just like on the 11 Pro, we have a frosted glass back and a non-frosted camera bump. And of course, the big design change is the flat sides. These look amazing. And I have the stainless steel, of course, with the 12 Pro, and you can already see my heat transfer and fingerprints getting on the side there. Let me see if you can see that, but it is picking it up pretty quick. So instantly after picking it up out of the box, you can feel the design difference. The flat sides, for me, make a big difference already just in the grip. Just a quick comparison with my iPhone 11 Pro, the rounded edges always felt pretty slippery for me, a little hard to hold. And with the flat sides, you can actually get more grip on the side of the phone, which is going to be nice, I think. So, super excited for that. So we'll just put this to the side for a second. What else do we have in the box? We have designed by Apple in California. We have a SIM tool and a Apple sticker. We have a USB-C to Lightning cable. And that's it. Back to the phone. All right. God, this blue is just awesome. Really, really nice. I like that a lot. And I really like the stainless steel edges as well, and the buttons are very flat. I don't know if you can see that very well, but the buttons are very flat as well. Raised up, of course, from the edge, but just a very nice feel, even before actually clicking them. Should we click them? We'll click them. Yeah, they click. So one of the first things that I wanted to know with the new iPhone 12 series is how it was going to feel in my hand. And after just a few minutes, I have a couple of impressions. And of course, after using it for a few days, hopefully I'll have a better idea, a more cogent thought, if you will, on how I feel about this. One of the things that I was most curious about over these last few weeks is what was it going to feel like to hold? So over the last couple days, I've been picking up more frequently my iPhone 4 series and 5 series phones that have flat sides, flat edges, and just trying to picture in my mind what it was going to feel like to hold the iPhone 12 Pro. And as it turns out, even though they're smaller and lighter, just because, you know, they're much easier to hold in your hand securely versus something like the iPhone 11 Pro and basically all the way back to the iPhone 6, I feel like I actually just have to hold on a bit tighter, squeeze a bit tighter with these rounded edges so the phone doesn't fall out of my hand. Versus something with flat edges where it just feels like you have more surface area for your fingers to hold on to. And when you pick up the iPhone 12, you can instantly feel that same thing. It feels much easier to hold. It feels a little bit lighter than my iPhone 11 Pro. And it's just a tad taller. You can see that a little bit. Let me see, try that, there you go. And it's just a tad wider as well. So if we put them on top of each other, you just have a little bit more room on this side. One thing I was worried about is the size difference. I used to have plus size phones and I like them. I've had Samsung S9 Plus and I've had the plus size iPhones and I liked them. However, I did grow more fond of the smaller regular size iPhone 11 Pro. And I think it's the perfect size for me with the 5.8 inch screen. So I was a little bit worried getting this guy that it's just even slightly bigger. And you can feel it in the hand. I can actually feel it. It's not that much on paper if you look at the dimensions, but you can feel the difference. Even with the flat sides, you can still feel the difference of the width. Now, I'm sure that's something that I can get over after just a couple of days of using it, but this really does make me excited to try out the iPhone 12 mini because I think that smaller size is just gonna feel great. So just a quick comparison of the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 11 Pro. On the backs, you got the Pacific blue over here and the midnight green over here. and they both look really cool. Actually, together they look really cool. Now, they both have a similar camera bump on the back with three cameras. Of course, there's wide, ultra wide, and zoom, and I'm not sure which one is which. The iPhone 12 Pro has LiDAR for faster face detection, faster autofocus in low light, and you can do portrait mode in low light or night mode now. And they both have, of course, True Tone for flash, and yeah. On the right side of the phone, both of them have their power button. Of course, the iPhone 12's is more flat versus the 11 Pro's rounded button. The iPhone 12 also has this 5G antenna band right here versus the SIM slot on the iPhone 11 Pro. If we go to the left side, we have the SIM slot on the 12 Pro, and then of course both have volume, rocker, and mute switch. The bottom of the phones both have the same speaker and microphone layout. The only other difference really is that the iPhone 12 Pro is going to have completely flat glass on the front, which probably hard to tell here, versus the 2D glass or whatever it's called on the iPhone 11 Pro, where it's rounded just a little bit at the edges as it flows into the curvature of the sides. Here's just a quick size comparison if you're interested. I have the iPhone 11, the 12 Pro, the 11 Pro, 6S, 5, 4, and 3G. I also got a couple of MagSafe cases from Apple. I have the blue silicone, I have the clear case, and I have this OtterBox Figura case. It's exclusive to the Apple Store, I believe. They have a couple of different colors. It's ever so slightly bigger than the silicone case from Apple and the clear case, maybe about a millimeter taller and wider. So it's not a huge bulky case that you would expect from OtterBox. But on the inside, you can kind of see that it almost seems like it was hacked together for MagSafe, which of course I have a MagSafe charger right here. So let's throw this guy in the case and test him out, see what we think. So first we'll do the OtterBox and it just snaps in, and right away it feels pretty good. Again, those flat sides really do help, I think, with the grippability, and it doesn't feel as slippery in my hand. The buttons on this guy are plastic, which is nice. They're a little bit more rigid than the buttons on the silicone case or the clear case. These ones feel a little rubbery, but the plastic buttons on this OtterBox case feel pretty good, and they feel nice and tactile, like you know you're hitting the button. No weak buttons here. So with the MagSafe puck, we can just pop it on the back and we'll see the phone start to charge. There we go, 86%. And that guy shouldn't go anywhere, although you can just easily pull the phone off, and yeah, it does hang there. It does hang there. So first impression of the OtterBox case is that it feels pretty good. Let's try the blue navy, or navy blue, or deep navy, or whatever it's called. When you put the Apple cases on there, it recognizes the Apple case through NFC or something inside, and it kind of popped up a little circle color there. Let me show you again. So watch the color pop. There you go. Charging puck. And it works. How these buttons feel. So these ones feel a little bit more squishy for sure, not like the more rigid buttons on the OtterBox. I am definitely so far a fan of the OtterBox buttons more so than the Apple silicone case. Oops, picture. The cutout and speaker holes on the bottom and around the phone look obviously like they're aligned correctly. I know some people have gotten cases without the holes on the bottom for the speakers and microphones, so luckily for me and luckily for us, we did not have that issue. And the clear case is gonna give us a white color pop. Maybe. There it goes. Snapped in, we're snapped on, we're charging. All right. And this one, just like the blue silicone case, feels a little bit squishy in the buttons. So I am not a fan so far of Apple's cases as far as button clickiness. They could definitely be a little more clicky. And of course, this guy just spins around and pops on and off. I wonder if, let's try this. Try again. Well, that's not working. And that's pretty much it. That's the unboxing of the iPhone 12 Pro in Pacific Blue. I'm gonna throw this iCares matte screen protector on it because I love these things. I can use my phone outside or where it's bright and not just see myself in the screen reflecting back at me. But what do you wanna know about this phone? What do you want me to compare it against on previous iPhones? Do you want me to do speed tests, app tests, load tests, video tests, what? Let me know below. Hit subscribe to be sure that you see the upcoming videos and the bells, of course, for notifications. And I'll see you next time.